Hello, hello, hello. Happy 2021-ish. Here we go. Hey folks, yeah, whole new year. The cut from last year, please God, starts disappearing into the past. And we can move forward. But where are we moving to? Where's the strange little world gonna go to? Where's your world gonna go to? Well, just think about my industry, okay? The events industry. I was in the industry for a long time, still consulting it. But lockdown came, crash, everyone disappears, people start running around trying to do virtual events, LED screen stuff, and this goes out, and we do our best, and everyone does their best. But hey, definitely no balloon for the winning party. Hey, it's been a bit of a disaster for everyone, marketing in general. But I think most people admit that even before lockdown, for the last couple of years, events and I think promotions and marketing in general has taken a bit of a slide. And you know, at this time of life, while we're looking at picking the pieces up and moving forward, it might be a good idea to have a look and see what actually fucked our industry up. Well, a couple of things, eh? I think, of course, backhands, we all know bribery and corruption in this country. And that has tainted the pot, meaning that the gut best are not necessarily doing the best work. Or if they are, there's a middleman in between, which is taking the cream off the cake, the first three layers of the cake, and leaving the sort of the board at the bottom. So that's hurt the industry. Who makes the decisions in the corporates? I think to me it looked more like financial directors are making the decision as opposed to the marketing directors. Or the production people, or people that are on the know. So let's work this out. So it comes on price. Normally, the corporate goes through a preferred supplier who is on the books, because you have to be on their list of preferred suppliers. You cannot, obviously, procurement. You cannot just walk in the front door. And again, how are those selections made? Are they made on creative, on story, or credentials of the client for having done great events and stuff like that? Which also comes into question is how we actually judge these events. I mean, debriefing, I've had experience before where you put a debriefing to the client and to the production team and the agency. Jesus, everyone else at the table had made these beautiful briefs, production briefs or post-mortems, which blowed smoke each up each other's ass. But is that the purpose of the debrief? Is it to turn around and make sure that all of us think we've done wonderfully, even if we haven't? And that job we hadn't. We hadn't done wonderfully. And maybe that's the case. If it's going to client, there should be two post-mortems, one for the production team, for the people, the factory, and the other to go to client to blow smoke up their asses. I don't know, but maybe still give the other one to the client as well, so that he knows what's going on and he knows that you take his business serious. So the evaluation awards as well. I question sometimes the integrity of award. I mean, maybe that's out of line for me to say, but you know, why do always the big clients win? You know, the big agencies and the big brands and stuff, because it's marketing for them as well. I mean, let's face it. I mean, we need to become honest. We need to start evaluating what's good, not necessarily who was the team that produced the winning piece. That's what's fucking good, man. Going back to the basics. What else? Creative. Okay, so now we've got the agency, the client gives the brief to the agency or to a bigger production house, puts it out for spec, goes out to all these guys that know that they are going to be judged on price, first of all. So everyone scrams to try and put as much crap into it as possible for as cheap as possible. And guess what? We get a Chinese product, don't we? We get a product, and I don't say that with disrespect, sorry, but we get a shitty product, okay? We get product where the ends are loose, there's loose ends, something goes wrong, the whole thing falls apart, it hasn't been based on a strong foundation. And that's why, and the events become mediocre at best, poor. More likely, and don't judge it just by the flashing lights and stuff, guys. The event must be done by the story. Any kind of communication should be judged on the story. We are creating stories that appeal to certain target audiences with the idea of actually resonating with them and making them want us as part of their lives. That's what we do for our brands. So just throwing in the sushi and a couple of flashy moving heads doesn't actually cut it. Who wrote the script? How does the script tie in to the reception, registration, into pre-drinks? How does the whole story line up, and what is the journey? How are you romancing your audience? But we don't have to do that anymore, don't do we? I mean, Corona came along, and then along came Corona, and fucked the whole cat, didn't it? So what happens? So we start moving into different spaces, everyone starts going into LED and going into green screen, and started jumping around and bragging about it, but I looked at it and it was actually, it didn't blow my socks off. Not what we've done so far. What are we trying to do? We're trying to take LED screens and then put a backdrop on and put artists in front of them. And then we're getting artists to perform on stages, and because there's no audience, we don't put a PA in. We just give them earpieces. That doesn't get the magic of the room. A PA costs you a couple of speakers, costs you a couple of bob. Put the room, set that room up without the tables and chairs, although a couple would be nice for a couple of cutaways with just a couple of actors and stuff. A crowd shot kind of shit. It could be quite nice to add a touch. But then we put on this background screen, which means any kind of side shots get lost. We shouldn't be making the LED, the virtual events based on events. We should be basing our virtual events on movies, on CG, on science fiction movies, you know, LED green screen. So in other words, shoot the guy green screen and create your whole set in 3D. And then place the person on the set. Doesn't that make a hell of a lot more sense than putting a guy in front of an LED screen with a set on the screen? Just the way you'd actually structure the event is slightly so different. But what do we have to do? So we have to go back to basics, okay? Sorry, I've jumped around, but going back to the first train of thought. For this whole Corona and moving forward, wouldn't it be great if first of all we worked out payment structures? How do we actually pay suppliers? How do we actually, and as we know, we know the same thing. I mean, 100% of it don't play, because we know we've all been burnt before. But the salary structures, and get people to be realistic and clients to be realistic what we're producing. We can produce a lot cheaper now, because if we're using 3D sets, we're not building sets, we don't have venues, we don't have decor, we don't have all of this thing is 3D, it's virtual. And we're dropping our artists, our performers, everyone in. So how are we going to do it? I think instead of creating it like eBay or something like that, we should be emulating the real experience. And as we go further, we can emulate it further. When we start bringing VR into the equation, picture your guests coming along and having each an avatar. They can sign in with a username and password. They get an avatar. They can walk around. They can intermingle. They could even speak, because if the VR is set up correctly, you could actually limit frequencies to go to certain conversations, say people sitting at a table. This should be going into the retail space as well. Instead of just, you know, like sort of catalogs online, create virtual malls. Let's create these people where I walk through, I can go into a shop, I can see their game, I can walk into game, and game is buying space in the mall, in this virtual mall. It becomes not just one shop, it becomes a mall, and I can walk in and I can see a product and I can pick the product up and I can look at it, I can turn it around virtually. I can then click on it, go straight through to the supplier that's been designated that then delivers it, get up to my house. The experience is a shopping experience. This could be for libraries, entertainment, everything we want to move. Instead of us trying to fit in with the computer's world, wouldn't it be nice if we could get the computer to fit in with our world? I think we're going there. I mean, all the AI and stuff is amazing. It's going to fuck us out of the workplace, and we've got to come up with something novel to start with. Which means how we actually use our tools. The tools are there. We've just got to invent the ways to actually make them serve us, as opposed to us just servicing them. And yeah, I think we're going into exciting times for marketing and advertising. And guys, let's get back to ideas. Let's go back to the big idea. Let's come up with great ideas. I mean, we haven't got billboards anymore because no one's on the fucking roads, is it? So half of the shit, the outdoor has gone for bullshit. television, yeah, ideas are so corny, they are so literal, they're so insulting. Let's get clever again. Let's get great ideas. Let clever guys, the young guys that come up with these ideas, give them the rope to actually present these things. And then don't the middle management try and suck all the fame. Pass the fame down. Let's re-energize this industry. And let's pass the money down. Let's get this thing rich. And give value to money for clients. And clients, you guys out there, understand, we have got a big role. And we actually affect your business. How do I know that? Because doing it badly for the last couple of years has affected your business. It hasn't actually worked. Your promoters are cuck. Your shopping center promotions are cuck. All of this shit is people. You've got bodies and you've got infrastructure, logistics. That's about it. Anyone say the glitch? Yeah, a little bit of glitch. Is it what expected? Did it actually change people's minds? Did it turn your brand into a brand and not just another commodity? Think about this. It's not the financial director, peace be with you, my brother. Yeah, we want your money. So I'm singing to you, where must I blow the smoke? He says, yeah, we are. But let your marketing team do their job. Give them a budget, marketing team. Don't try and set up a golf course if you've only got money to prepare the green. Do the green beautifully. Make sure that everyone wants to play on that green. Don't just fuck up the golf course. Anyway, yeah, that's about my little story for starting 2021. I'm going to be consulting a lot of this. Anyone looking for some wacky ideas, some interesting times, and some full of shithole man, I could add value to your business in your marketing, your events, and your promotions. Hope to hear from you, Shot.